Ultra-fast internet will soon be available to some 8 million Australian properties, with the government announcing a $4.5 billion upgrade to the NBN. But the opposition says it's all a wasteful backflip.
Whether you've been working or schooling or shopping from home, the pandemic has made it abundantly clear. Ultra-fast internet has never been more important.
We're transferring large video files all the time, and quite often I have to drive all the way home to upload larger files because it takes so long with ADSL2.
Paul Hoad is hoping he won't have to go back and forth much longer, with the federal government announcing a $3.5 billion upgrade to the NBN.
That's blazing fast broadband.
Giving 8 million Aussie homes access to speeds of up to 1 gigabit per second by 2023.
It was clear to us at NBN that we're going to see an increasing digitisation of the economy.
And that will be delivered through an upgrade to fibre to the premises.
If that sounds familiar...
One.
It's because it was a central feature of Labor's original plan, which the Coalition fought against for years.
A scandalous waste of money. Unbelievably wasteful.
Tony Abbott described it as school halls on steroids, but now 7 years after he and Malcolm Turnbull gave it the axe, it's back.
It's the most extraordinary, wasteful, humiliating backflip in public policy in a generation.
But the government insists it's not the same.
I mean, there's multiple differences. I could go on for days about the differences.
For one,
we'll roll the fibre down the street, but we will only connect the fibre lead into the home when a customer orders a service that needs fibre.
This is a monumental policy backflip by the Morrison government.
The Coalition expects the uptake will be strong, reasoning customers are now more willing to pay for ultra-fast internet and there'll be no upfront connection fees. The upgrade will be financed by the NBN's private borrowings. Tegan George for 10 News First.